Queensland, Australia, the challenger, the Australian heavyweight champion and Asia Pacific heavyweight champion, the Samoan fighting pride of Australia, Alex the Lionheart Leapai. And fighting out of the red corner, wearing red with gold, official weight 112.2 kilos. His professional record stands at 61 victories, including 52 knockouts with 3 defeats, and he is undefeated during his 10-year rule as the heavyweight champion of the world. From Kiev, Ukraine, 3-time world champion, the reigning, defending, universally recognized, undisputed heavyweight champion of the world, Dr. Steelhammer, Wladimir Klitschko!
Klitschko and Leapai for the heavyweight championship as Eddie Cotton, the U.S. veteran referee, is the third man inside the ropes.
All right, boxers. You both received my instructions in the dressing room. I expect you to obey my commands. Protect yourself at all times. Let's touch gloves. I expect a good, clean fight. Let's touch gloves. Let's touch them.
Teddy, Noel Thornberry, the trainer for Alex Leapai, said, I believe we can win because Alex has tremendous punching power and Klitschko doesn't handle pressure well. I've heard you say all week long in the lead up to this broadcast, it's one thing to have power, it's another thing to be able to deliver it. Is that the key to this tonight?
Yeah, you can have a bomb, you know, you can have an explosive device, but if you don't have a means to convey it to the target, a missile in other words, well, then it has no value to you. And it's the same thing with the power of Leapai. Unless he has a means to deliver it to the target, in this case, the chin of Klitschko, it has no value. And to do that, he has to get close enough to catch Klitschko, as you can see, as he pulls back. And how do you get close enough? Well, one thing is you move your head and you move your feet. You move your head to the side, get outside his jab, and then move your feet forward and take steps to converge on Klitschko, to close the gap. Right now, it looks like Leapai, at least he's got one part down. He's moving his head, and he's trying to move the feet forward. You are not going to win a fight if there's distance between you and Klitschko.
Of course, Wladimir Klitschko, 6'6", Leapai 6', and there is exactly that 6-inch difference in their measured reach.
He's got the right idea, Leapai. Again, moving his head, trying to avoid that pole, which is a jab of Klitschko's, and then moving his feet to try to close that gap. Looked like he got caught on top of the head there.
There's a knockdown scored here just over a minute into round one.
Body language of Leapai is good, though. Doesn't look hurt, and he's acting like the referee made a mistake. He's basically saying that he slipped on some of those graphics, some of the painting in the middle of the ring, which sometimes can get very slippery. So far, I believe Leapai. He doesn't look hurt. But if he eats any more of those right hands, that might change.
See, Klitschko setting up the table behind that jab, was able to land the power of the right hand moments ago.
Yeah, that's what Klitschko does. You know, I mean,
stop.
If you go to dinner in the average household, you use your knife to prepare your food and your fork to eat it. In the ring, Klitschko's jab is the knife and the right hand is his fork. That's how he eats. And the meal in front of him right now, 248-pound Leapai. One thing that I don't like is the weight of Leapai, Joe. Came in heaviest of his career. Heck of a time to be coming in the heaviest of your career when you're in with the biggest threat of your career.
Leapai checked in at 248 pounds on that 6-foot frame. Klitschko's 247 and a half.
Klitschko's defense and offense work together. Defense to stay away. His offense is to have enough range to catch you at the end of his jab.
So a steady and predictable first round for the heavyweight champion Wladimir Klitschko with a knockdown score.
You gonna count for knockdown? Are you gonna count for knockdown?
Here's a look back at that jab that put down Leapai.
Again, the jab obviously landing that ramrod pole of a jab. That one gets in. The second one gets hit. First one a little high up around the bridge of the nose. The second one lower near the chin. There you can see a left hook getting in. Second left hook was blocked by the glove of Leapai. You know, that left hook can really be underestimated by opponents with Klitschko. They're so busy looking for the right hand. That left hook has a heaviness to it, and it has a stickiness to it, where you're looking for the right hand so much that quite often Klitschko winds up hurting guys with the left hook. They're just not expecting it.
So all that steady work with the jab from Klitschko in round one. Among his superlatives, calculated by CompuBox, Klitschko averages 10 jabs per round. That is the most in the heavyweight division.
And there's two kinds of jabs. I'm glad you brought up the jab. There's two versions of a jab for Klitschko. One is the setup, the range finder. The other one is the destructive punch that he's using right now, the one that pushes through and does damage and sets up the right hand. The other one, again, just a range finder. Right now he's using the aggressive one, the destructive one.
And in that first round, he did land 10 jabs, so he's right on his average.
Yeah, there will be time you see that adjustment where Klitschko will just float that jab out. Right now, again, snapping it out. Always, always looking to set up really the punch that he wants to land, the right hand.
And Leapai has seen a couple of those blinded right hands where he's moving the jab away just as the right hand is then coming through after it.
Well, that's what he tries to do. That's Klitschko's Sunday punch, his forte. Blind you with the jab, mesmerize you with the jab, brush stroke your eyes with the jab, and then have a right hand right behind it where your brain had no time to register a right hand was coming. No time to steel yourself. No time to prepare yourself. And the right hand puts you to sleep. That's exactly. Just look at it. That's what Klitschko's doing. Trying to catch Leapai blind. In other words, take his vision with the jab. And then at the right time, let a right hand come right behind it. Ingemar Johansson. For you great fight fans out there, years ago, knocked out Floyd Patterson for the heavyweight title. Just that way. Blinded him with the jab, hit him with the thunderbolt, the right hand.
With that consistent work rate of Klitschko behind the jab, we are seeing hardly any offense out of Leapai.
You know, if it's not broke, don't fix it. A lot of people say, Teddy, Klitschko has no versatility. You're right, but it's not broke. He's not fixing it. He's good at one thing. There's something to be said at being good and effective at one thing. Controls range real well, keeps you where it's bad for you, good for him. And again, uses that long jab to set up the right hand.
Coming to the end of round number two, Wladimir Klitschko in control. ESPN's boxing special is presented by Corona Extra, who invites you to find your beach. Joe Tessitore and Teddy Atlas with you. Coverage of the heavyweight championship of the world, Wladimir Klitschko's 25th championship fight in his career. Round number three against the underdog challenger, the Samoan-born, Australian-based Alex Leapai.
Even though you look at Leapai, you see it. You know, thick across the shoulders. You know, you see a heavy, strong-looking man. Well, he was a smaller man when he turned pro, only 215, Joe. Even weighed 207 in his second and third fights. While Klitschko, he was 220 when he first turned pro. He's always been the bigger and more natural heavyweight, no matter what the perception might be. Again, when you see the thicker Leapai.
Leapai just trying to move that head out of the way. He came out lunging with a left hand open up this third round, but now falling back into the style we saw earlier.
And now you're seeing a version of the other jab of Klitschko that I alluded to earlier. You're seeing where he's just pushing it out there, just measuring with it, keeping Leapai in front of him, looking to do that, set up the finishing blow, the right hand. You're not seeing that damaging jab right now.
There's a right hand off the top of the head, landed by Klitschko.
You're seeing that decoy jab right now. Decoy. Just keeping him busy, keeping him where he wants him, and then looking to sneak in the right hand. You are seeing a little more versatility from Klitschko than I've seen in the past, Joe. You know, mixing up uppercuts, showing a little bit more of a range of punches, a little more of a repertoire of punches than usually when you only see that jab and right hand down the middle. I think the reason you're seeing that, he's very comfortable with Leapai. I mean, he's got a punching bag with gloves on in front of him right now, who's not closing the gap.
He cannot close the gap at all with that steady jab. There he comes, windmilling in with a right hand, and Klitschko just easily steps away and gets back to business.
This style for an opponent like Leapai, it's all, not only does it deteriorate you physically, but mentally, it frustrates you because you start to lose hope. Because if you can't touch the other man, how do you have hope?
Three-punch combination landed sharply by Klitschko. And there comes the thudding right hand again.
And again, the distance where Leapai is standing right now is good for Klitschko. Impossible for Leapai, because Leapai cannot win on the outside.
End of three. We're thrilled to be bringing you on ESPN the complete heavyweight title picture in a span of 2 weeks. 2 weeks from today, May 10th, the other piece of the heavyweight title puzzle as two hopefuls fight for it. Chris Areola, the popular Mexican-American from Southern California, against Berman Stavern in a rematch. They fought a year ago. Stavern got the best of them. Now they'll fight for the WBC heavyweight title live on ESPN. That's Saturday, May 10th, 8 o'clock Eastern. For now, round number four of the guy who has all the other belts, Wladimir Klitschko. The only one he's missing is that WBC belt that his brother vacated. He's the lineal champion, by all accounts, the recognized heavyweight champion of the world, in complete control against Alex Leapai.
Most of the fights for Leapai, most of Leapai's fights have been in Australia. This is only his second time fighting in Germany. See how well he travels here? Not so good. It's been a bumpy ride so far. Klitschko has fought in Germany, Joe, 47 times. Matter of fact, some people consider him more German than Russian.
Ukrainian born, of course, has made his career here in Germany, where he's widely popular, splits time living in Germany and in South Florida.
And the rest of his time, he spends fighting guys that don't know how to get close.
That's right. And a long, long title reign of guys trying to close that gap and unable to do so since his last loss back in April of 2004. This would be his 16th straight title defense. That is being ruled a slip by Eddie Cotton.
For you great historians out there, only Joe Louis and Larry Holmes have more heavyweight title defenses. Joe Louis, 25. Larry Holmes, 20. Again, it's all about range. It's all about distance in a Klitschko fight. And right now, the range to distance, exactly what Klitschko wants with those long arms, with that wingspan. He can expand those arms and keep his opponent downhill.
Teddy, is there any point where Leapai just has to go for broke, and if it causes him, you know, reckless encounter and massive damage trying to get through that bad neighborhood to get to the inside, he goes for it, eats a huge right hand?
Yeah, there's a point. The point's there now. Right now, he needs to start doing that, because more of this can't lead to anything positive. He gets disintegrated more and more mentally, more and more physically. The referee starts to look at it, see how one-sided it is. That time for going for broke is upon us.
Series of right hands raining in here in the final minute of round number four as Leapai struggles to find an answer against Klitschko. Joe Tessitore and Teddy Atlas with coverage here of the heavyweight championship fight, Klitschko and Leapai. You just brought up what it would mean if he defends the title today. 16 straight, Lewis 25 straight, Larry Holmes 20. But knowing this era of heavyweights that he's been on this run against, how do you stack up Wladimir Klitschko historically?
No Joe Lewis, no Larry Holmes. I'm sorry, not to knock what he's done. Numbers don't lie. They're great. They're terrific. I applaud him. More importantly, he gets paid well for producing those numbers, so I don't have to applaud him. But he has three losses, Klitschko, all three by knockout. And the names, the level of those losses, those kind of guys never beat Joe Lewis, and they never beat Larry Holmes, Lamont Brewster, Corey Sanders, Ross Purity. Some of you are going to say, who? Well, exactly my point. Who? That level, those kind of opponents, again, never beat the great Joe Lewis, and they didn't beat Larry Holmes.
Vitaly Klitschko, older brother, looking on here. He vacated his WBC title belt. Chris Areola and Berman Stavern will fight for that vacant piece of the heavyweight title May 10th on ESPN from Los Angeles.
You don't want to stand in front of any opponent, not just Klitschko, but Klitschko can make you pay a bigger price than most opponents if you stand in front. That happens. You get hit with a right hand off a blind jab. And that's exactly what happens when you stand right in front of a guy with the length and size and power that Klitschko has. And there he goes.
Big thudding blow from Wladimir Klitschko.
A lot of time left. 1 minute, 10 seconds, an eternity for a fighter that's been hurt and is in front of a guy that so far he's had no ability to get close to.
Second knockdown of the round. Leapai absolutely pummeled and hopeless here. Victory, Wladimir Klitschko, yet again. Straight title defenses now for Klitschko. Teddy, it went exactly the way you thought the script would play out.
Yeah, unfortunately, Leapai went along with the script and the script makers. And here you see why. Stood right in front. That time it wasn't a jab setting it up. It was a left hook, a throwaway left hook. There it is, a throwaway left hook just to set up the right hand, the payoff punch, the money punch, right down the middle. You know, the script, if you wrote the script and you were the script writer and you were Klitschko, you'd say, stand in front of me, stand back a little bit where I could get full extension on my punches. Of course, if you were the script writer for Leapai, you'd want to get close. Unfortunately, Leapai did not have that script writer. He stood outside, right in front of Klitschko, at the perfect distance where only one man could win. Adequacy of these opponents.
Guys like David Haye and Mormek. Most recently, Alexander Povetkin back in October. And tonight, you can add the name of Alex Leapai, a former truck driver down in Australia who hit the jackpot pulling an upset against the number one contender to cash in here tonight against Klitschko and hit the deck three times, TKO'd in round number five by Wladimir.
Unfortunately, the truck driver was dumped right there by a punch that has dumped a lot of guys, the right hand of Klitschko.
23-2 with 18 knockouts now in world title bouts.
Ladies and gentlemen, at 2 minutes and 5 seconds of round number five, referee Eddie Cotton waves off the count following the second knockdown of that round and calls this fight the winner by knockout victory and still recognized as the universal undisputed heavyweight champion of the world, Wladimir Dr. Steelhammer Klitschko!
It's only a matter of time.